This is the SAP Developer News for July 4th, 2024.
Hola, SAP developers. I don't know about you, but I've learned a lot from the sample code that's available in the SAP samples organization on GitHub. Whatever you're interested in, be it CAP, RAP, AI, connectivity with event brokers, it is likely that you will find a good sample in the repos available there. For example, the latest cool repo that I bumped into is the BTP Resource Consumption Monitor by my colleague Willen, who recently also published a blog post about what the tool can do for you. In essence, keep track of your CPA, BTP EA credits. The tool has a bunch of things: billing verification, cost breakdown, credit expenditure, monitor analytics, even suggestions for account optimization and cost reduction strategies. And all the code and details to get it running are there for you to explore. Make sure to check it out. I'm including the links in the description below.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. I'm on an early morning walk with a little one who for some reason seems to be sleeping better outdoors, and I thought I would use the time wisely and record the developer news. So we would like to point your attention to two customer engagement initiatives that are currently running. The first one is about SAP UI5 2.0. So the team's looking for feedback and is willing to provide some more insights and help on how to migrate from SAP UI5 version 1 to 2. The second initiative is about SAP BTP and is specifically for SAP BTP admins and solution architects. Again, the team is looking for feedback and is willing to provide some more insights and help with the overall goal of improving the user experience on the platform. These initiatives are really your chance to shape the future of those two products, and I very much invite you to participate. And I see you soon. Bye.
The June Developer Challenge, run by my good friend and colleague Vitaly, is coming to a close. It's not too late to finish off the tasks, though. But July is here, and that means we have a new Developer Challenge for you. We're calling it Reverse APIs, because essentially it's a reflection on last August's Developer Challenge on APIs. But this time, it's you that have to create the APIs, API endpoints in services that will be tested by an automatic testing mechanism. Sounds scary? Not at all, because you'll have the power and magic of CAP at your disposal. The whole idea is to learn, to explore, to discover all the features that CAP has to offer when building services and API endpoints. There are 10 tasks in this challenge, reflecting 10 different API endpoints that you're going to create over 3 different services over the course of this month, plus a little warm-up task, task 0, that is an easy way to start off. And that task 0 has already been published. Head over to the blog post, which explains everything and links you to this first task to get going. See you online.
Hello everybody! I hope you're all having a good time. Are you an IT administrator or IT professional looking to streamline and scale your SAP Build Fusion development efforts? Then it is crucial to have a robust governance framework in place. Effective governance ensures that your organization's software projects are delivered quickly, securely, efficiently, and in alignment with your organizational goals and compliance requirements. SAP has now launched SAP Build Governance Resource Center website. Inside this webpage, you will find a package of valuable assets like Digital Center of Excellence Toolkit, Use Case Buddy Tool, How to Guide for Use Cases Ideation and Fusion Development Project Lifecycle Management, Guided Experience Step-by-Step Tutorial, FAQs, Presentation on SAP Build Governance, Essential Quick Links, and SAP Help Documentation Links for Best Practices. By consolidating all the resources I just mentioned into a single and easy-to-navigate platform, SAP Build Governance Resource Center empowers you to operate and scale your Fusion development programs with confidence. I hope you found this update exciting. Thank you.
A couple of years ago, we launched the Open Documentation Initiative to encourage you to collaborate with us on documentation, either by providing feedback or contributing fixes and improvements to the documentation via the universal global content collaboration mechanism and platform that is GitHub. Recently, you might have noticed that there's also been some revamping of an existing feature directly on the SAP Help Portal. That's the comments feature, which some may find more straightforward to use to contribute comments while perusing the documentation. We want to know what you prefer. Jens Haley has written a blog post all about this new revamp and also describing what we want to achieve by asking you to help us find out the difference between the two approaches. Read all about it in Jens's blog post. The link is in the description.